Have you ever planned for a lazy day to get a rest from your busy day-to-day life, but when it came, you ended up feeling out of schedule and wishing you were back at work?
The truth is, humans have a built-in clock, and by implementing routines into our day-to-day life and creating consistency in our actions, we can really improve our health. I'm not a scientist, but the best piece of advice I got this year in 2021 was to apply consistent sleeping, eating, and exercising habits as a way to improve my well-being. Big thanks to the man Andrew Huberman for the constant knowledge on his podcast, and a big thanks to the sponsor of today's video, Shut Eye. First of all, what is a circadian rhythm? Okay, let me give you the scientific explanation and let me give you how I would describe it to a friend. According to the National Institute of General Medical Sciences, circadian rhythms are physical, mental, and behavioral changes in our systems that follow a 24-hour cycle. Some important biological processes that help regulate the circadian rhythm are our sleep-wake cycle, which comes about with the production of melatonin, which many of you may have heard of already, body temperature, feeding, hormonal secretion, glucose homeostasis, and cell cycle regulation. Please tell me I did that right. Okay, now let me give you how I would describe circadian rhythm. In simple terms, the circadian rhythm helps us regulate and perceive our sense of time. And this can be beneficial for other species, not just humans. For example, on Andrew Huberman's podcast, they'd give an example that if an animal has the wrong sleep-awake time, this could be really bad if their predators are going to attack them during that time where they're asleep. So even for animals, having that rhythm of sleep-wake and eating can be a matter of survival. But in general, the circadian rhythm is really good for humans to get into a routine and understand, okay, it's night outside, it's time to go to bed, because that's what the rest of the society does. Or maybe every day 12 o'clock rolls around and you're thinking, I haven't eaten yet today, it's time to eat. Now, that's just a little bit of science behind the circadian rhythm, or our internal clock, and why it's really important for us to know about it and understand how we can help this system thrive. But the truth is, I'm not a scientist and I'm not going to pretend to be one. So let me just tell you ways that I've implemented scheduling to help improve my circadian rhythm and in turn feel a lot better in general and have a lot more energy throughout the day. The first form of scheduling I've implemented to help myself feel better is sleep schedule. And before you think, duh, we all need to sleep. But do you go to sleep the same time every night and wake up at the same time every morning? I've always thought that I've had a good sleep schedule. And then I realized that my first 2 years at university, I was out late some nights and up really early to get to class or to study or get to work. And my sleep schedule was all over the place. And that's probably why for those 2 years, I felt really low energy throughout. This kind of continued for the pandemic, but it brings me to here where I'm living in Valencia. And because I have scheduled work time, I have to wake up at the same time every morning and in order to get my 9 hours of sleep, because I'm one of those people that need a lot of sleep, I have to go to bed at 11 p.m. And I found that that 11 p.m. to 8 a.m. schedule has given me infinite energy. I found the time that works for me. 9 hours is great, but you know, for you, you might only need 6 hours. Humans are all different. And just because that's my schedule doesn't mean that's the schedule that works for you. But I do really recommend trying to find what sleeping schedule is giving you the most energy throughout the day and try and be consistent with it. Now, of course, if you have a night out with friends, don't fret. I'm sure you will survive it. But for the most part, we should really be trying at least the other 6 days of the week to get consistent and regulated sleep. Getting good sleep is vital, and without good sleep, we have bad health. So I'm really happy to introduce the sponsor of today's video, Shut Eye. With over 3 million users, Shut Eye is an application that aims to track and monitor your sleep schedule and the quality of your sleep. We all understand how annoying it can be when you're in bed late at night and your brain doesn't want to turn off and you can't get yourself to stop thinking. And that's why my favorite part of the application is that they also have really cool sleep sounds and stories to help you fall asleep. My personal favorite is this. Another really cool feature is that there's a recording function to help you find out whether you snore and how this is affecting your sleep schedule or maybe affecting your partner's sleep schedule, which I think is something we're all interested in. I wish I could have someone tell me if I snore, and now with Shut Eye I can. So if you want to start prioritizing your sleep schedule and thus your circadian rhythm, download Shut Eye on the App Store or Google Play today. by clicking my link in the description below, and you can have access to 6 months of Shut Eye for only $20. $20 to help improve your daily life? Come on, that's only $3 for it to free a month. I think that's a great deal. Try it out and let me know down below what your favorite sleep sound is. I'm very interested. And thank you very much to Shut Eye for sponsoring today's video. Another way that I have implemented scheduling into my life, these two kind of go hand in hand, but for most people probably won't, is my exercising schedule and my seeing light schedule. I need to think of a better wording for that. Like I said, since I've come to Valencia, I have had ample energy and I was really trying to figure out why. In my head, I thought, maybe I'm just really happy to be doing my year abroad and I'm just really excited and that's giving me energy. But when I listened to Andrew Huberman's podcast, I learned that the times and the amount of time that you're seeing light each day can really affect your circadian rhythm and thus your energy. Now, I'd completely forgotten that every day I was waking up at 8 and I was going straight outside into light, walking 30 minutes before starting work. So whilst I was walking, I was getting all this good vitamin D from sunny Spain because I have yet to see a cloudy day here. And then when I would get to work, I would be so energized. And now going from a day where I was viewing sunlight for 2 hours, I will get into the 2 hours later, compared to when I was living in Scotland where it's always very cloudy, the sun quality is not very good, and I was not really outside that much. It's no wonder as to why I had so much more energy. Alongside the seeing lots of light a day, a way that's helped me get to sleep quicker is by cancelling out light by around 8 p.m. And that gives me 2 hours to stop having bright lights on my face. I try to turn my phone and laptop brightness down every night as well, which has really helped. And I'm very lucky that in Spain, and I know Italy as well, I have shutters that like really give me a blackout, and this has really helped me get to sleep quicker. And by doing this, it's like giving my body a sign like, hey, it's time to go to sleep. You're not out in direct sunlight right now. And yeah, try it out. Now, the 2 hours, let me calculate why I'm outside for 2 hours. Because this year I have implemented a good exercise routine that works for me, and that is just walking for 2 hours a day, roughly 10 kilometers. My habit is that I will walk at least 5, but every working day I walk 10 kilometers, and that is 2 hours. And the reason that this exercise works for me is because I have to get to work, so I know I have to do it at least 4 times a week, and do it because I don't feel like I'm working out. So low impact cardio every single day has done millions for me, and the fact that I can go a walk and see sunshine at the same time is like killing two birds with one stone. Maybe you prefer a 30 minute hardcore workout, and that's totally great too, but giving some form of exercise every day, we are no strangers to the fact that this is extremely beneficial for your health, but it is also very beneficial for your circadian rhythm. The last routine I have implemented to help my circadian rhythm is my eating schedule. And trigger warning for anyone who may not be comfortable with this topic. If so, please click off the video. Thank you for watching. But yes, I have been intermittent fasting for a good few years now. And recently I came home to my family house and I stopped intermittent fasting for around 2 weeks. And I realized how much it affects me just eating whenever I want and eating whatever I want. And since coming home, I have been straight back into the intermittent fasting. I've spoken about it before, but intermittent fasting is not starvation. It is instead scheduling a select amount of time to eat throughout the day. For me personally, what works is 1 p.m. to 8:30 p.m. because I live in Spain and people eat dinner at like 10 p.m. So that's really the earliest I can eat dinner without visiting a closed restaurant. But maybe for you, if you're from the UK, you could do 12 p.m. to 7 p.m. because I know a lot of us tend to eat between 5 and 7 p.m. So maybe that's better for you. And this was another thing in the podcast I keep talking about that I was, I guess, not surprised to hear. I knew how much eating during a selected window had really benefited my health, and maybe it would benefit yours too. So these are the 5 ways that I have implemented routine into my life where I can still have fun whenever I want and there's still a lot of time for free time, but I have set routines that are helping my circadian clock to thrive, to live its best life. Oh, I wanna know below, did you know what the circadian rhythm is? I mean, if you're a science major, you probably did, but if you aren't a science major like me, were you surprised to hear that we have this internal clock, or did it make sense to you? Thank you again to Shut Eye for sponsoring today's video, and thanks to Andrew Huberman for all of the knowledge. Here are 2 videos I recommend, and if not, that's okay. I hope you have a lovely day, and bye-bye.